It's the season to be jolly, falala. Oh, Christmas is already over. So is the holidays, guys, and we are now on 2017. Along with that is our first major tournament, ESL One Genting. You heard it right, guys. Our first major tournament for the year 2017 will be happening on the Southeast Asian region. So teams such as Fnatic, Digital Chaos, Wings Gaming, Team NP, Newbie, Virtus Pro, Warriors Gaming, Unity, and Execration will be competing for the tournament with a total prize pool of $250,000. Take note, guys, that we do have two brackets. Group A, Virtus Pro, Fnatic, Newbie, and NP, while Group B, Digital Chaos, Execration, Wings Gaming, and WG Unity. Top two of those brackets will move forward to the playoffs for that single eliminations best of three series, topping off with the best of five grand finals for this ESL One Genting. So without further ado, this is Kuya Nick from WomboX Combo, and let's jump into it. Here are the five things to look forward with the upcoming ESL One Genting. First is that this is going to be the first major tournament that will be using the patch 7.00. You heard it right, guys. The ever controversial 7.00 patch, wherein others are labeling it as basically a reset for Dota, but now they are already loving it. It's like what we told you earlier, this is the first major tournament. We've seen minor tournaments such as the European Pro Dota Cup together with the Royal Arena, with the Alliance, Empire, and other teams already playing with this patch. But for the Tier 1 teams, here is the first major tournament that we'll be seeing them use this 7.00 patch. So things to look forward, of course, are the new additions, the shrines and the talent trees together with the three additional backpacks. How will the pros use it? Will there be anything new that we'll be seeing with this current changes? Of course, alongside the changes are the Aghanim Scepter changes / upgrades. So aside from that one, will we be seeing also new meta coming from different top tier teams? Others are saying that this patch favors those teams with deep hero pool, which is Wings Gaming. Let's see how will they use the current patch into their advantage against other top tier teams. Second on their list is the new Fnatic lineup. How will it work? What are the changes? We already know that Demon, together with the Raven and AU, already departed the team. Rumors are spreading that Mushi will be reuniting with his longtime Malaysian teammate, also a legend in the scene, Yamate. If you don't know Yamate, just go to your Dota 1 application, play Shadow Fiend. You might have a chance to play SF with that Yamate name on it. Aside from Yamate, rumored teammates are the MMR Lord of Vietnam, which is In Your Dreams, together with the Korean mastermind Febby. Unfortunately for MVP, it's already confirmed that Febby, Dubu, and Forev already left the team together with QO. So let's see. Also, not to mention, Fnatic is one of the few teams who'll be attending multiple ESL One event, namely ESL One Frankfurt, ESL One Manila, and this upcoming ESL One Gentings. Next on our list is the Southeast Asian rivalry between Execration and WG Unity. We already know that Execration is one of the hottest team at the moment in the Southeast Asia, together with WG Unity. Given the roster changes in Execration, WG Unity, on the other hand, kept their five-man lineup and is now doing well with different tournaments. This Southeast Asian rivalry favors the Malaysian team WG Unity at the moment, having three best-of-five tournaments against Execration on their waist, namely the Pro Dota Cup, with them winning 2-3 versus Execration, and of course C Kappa Finals together with the Joint Dota League, with them sweeping Execration 3-0. So let's see how will Execration bounce back now that they don't have Abed already, their former hard carry Nando will be going back to the team, joining Kimo and Owo on the support position, DJ on the off lane, and their other prodigy Gabi, who will now be rotating on the mid lane. Next to look forward for this ESL 1 Genting is Virtus Pro. With the absence of Evil Geniuses and OG, can they be able to get another tournament after Summit 6? This CIS squad is notably one of the favorites coming into this tournament given their hot streak and of course their good showing with the previous Boston Majors. Ramses, No One, Pasha, Lil, and Solo all are hungry to have their winning streak already, which was negated by Evil Geniuses with the previous Boston Major. Lastly, the defending champions for ESL 1, Wings Gaming. They've won the previous ESL 1 installment, which was the ESL 1 Manila. That was their first big tournament prior to the TI6 win. Their orthodox game style really favors them with this current 7.00 patch. And their versatility with regards to their hero pool will really be noticed in this upcoming ESL 1 Genting. We've seen Wings Gaming on that China Top tournament wherein they were eliminated right ahead by their Western rival Evil Geniuses. But with the absence of Evil Geniuses, just like Virtus Pro, can they succeed on this ESL 1 Genting? That's one thing that we will look forward. That's it guys, that's our 5 things to look forward with the upcoming ESL 1 Genting. First was the 7.00 patch, second was the new Fnatic lineup, third is the Southeast Asian rivalry between XZ Creation, WG, and the fourth and fifth are the heavy favorites Virtus Pro and Wings Gaming. Do you think we missed anything that we should look forward with the upcoming major event? Do let us know by commenting it on the comment section, and please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for you to support what we are doing here in WomboX Combo. This is Kuya Nick again saying this is something I am really excited, and I know you guys are really excited too.